Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are in good health and high spirits. Students, in the previous part, we learned about how some students went on a picnic to Bhopal and on the way, they learned many new things from their teachers and from the surroundings. Let's move forward and enjoy their journey. Now, the students reach Bhimbetka. They get to know that Bhimbetka is a place where there are many caves which are around 10,000 years old. The students start counting pictures of ox and deer. One student says he counted 37 ox, and another student said he counted 117 deer. Can you tell by how much is the number of deer greater than the number of ox? For this, we will have to subtract them. Can you do it for me? I repeat it for you. Number of deer is 117, whereas the number of ox is 37. Can you subtract them and tell me? Just think, you can use your notebook and pens. I'm not gonna do it. You have to tell me. I hope you're doing it. Okay, now I'm going to tell you the answer and you can match your answers with mine. The number of deer is 80 more than the number of ox. I hope you got it right. But there was one student who was more than happy because she counted the number of people which was more than the number of ox and deer together. But her count was less than 200. Can you tell me how many people did she count? Was it 214? Was it 154? Was it 134? Or was it 177? Now see, she had counted that the number of people were more than the number of ox and deer together. Let's first find out what is the number of ox and deer together. So we add the number of ox and the number of deer. Number of ox were 37 and number of deer were 117. So we add them. You can do it yourself and the answer will be 154. Now, out of these four, we have to find a number which is more than 154 but less than 200. Just think, which number is that? I hope you can guess it. That number is 177. So that means the student had counted 177 people. Now the students felt very hungry as it was lunchtime. So all of them opened their tiffins. Biscuits, oranges and bananas were distributed amongst the students. each student got one orange, one banana and five biscuits. Each student got oranges and biscuits, but 38 students did not take bananas. Can you help me in finding how many oranges, how many biscuits and how many bananas were distributed? Now see, the total number of students were 210. And if all students got oranges and one orange each, so that means how many oranges were distributed? Yes, 210 were the number of students. One orange was given to each student. So the number of oranges that were distributed is 210. Now, 38 students didn't take banana. So how many students took bananas? We can subtract 38 from 210. I hope you can get me the answer. I'm giving you time to think. You can calculate it on your notebooks. Just do it. If 210 students were there and 38 students did not take bananas, so how many students were given bananas? We can subtract them. And the answer will be, I hope you have got it. It was 172. So 172 students were given bananas. Now see, each student was given 5 biscuits. So how many biscuits were distributed? See, there were 210 students and each student was given 5 biscuits. So to find the number of biscuits distributed, we will multiply 210 by 5. I won't do it. You have to get it for me. Just do it and tell me the answer. Quick, hurry up. How many biscuits were distributed? Okay, now I tell you, the answer is 1050. So 1050 biscuits were distributed. Now the students started playing with each other. They asked riddles. One student asked, if I give 4 toffees to 4 of my friends and still I am left with 3 toffees, then how many toffees did I have in the beginning? So see, there were 4 friends and each got 4 toffees. So how many toffees were distributed? 4 multiplied by 4, that is 16. And how many toffees are left? 3. So total toffees that he had in the beginning is 16 plus 3, that is 19 toffees. So this riddle was very easy. Now I am giving you one more riddle. You have to find its answer. You have to make some numbers using the digits 3, 5 and 7. I'm telling you two numbers like 357 and 537. So you won't use these two numbers. Apart from them, just think, how many numbers can you form? So this riddle is for you. you can solve it in your notebooks and you can also ask your friends. Now wait, I'm not gonna tell you its answer. This riddle is for you to solve. Let's move forward. Now, the students, as they were happy moving here and there, they saw a boating club. The students were so excited that they could do boating. They saw rates of different boats on a board. As you can see on your screen, the double decker boat, it had a fare 30 rupees for 45 minutes. Paddle boat, it had a fare 15 rupees for 30 minutes. Motorboat, it had fare 25 rupees for 20 minutes. And there was a rowing boat whose fare was 15 rupees for 45 minutes. Now, Indra and Bhanu first took a motorboat and then they took a rowing boat. Can you tell how much fare did they give in all? Now see, for motorboat, fare for one child is 25 rupees and fare for two children will be, can you tell? Yes, it will be 25 rupees multiplied by 2, that is 50 rupees. Similarly, on the rowing boat, fare for one child is 15 rupees and fare for two children will be 15 multiplied by 2, that is 30 rupees. So how much money did they have to pay? The fare for motorboat for two children was 50 rupees and the fare for rowing boat for two children was 30 rupees. So total fare for the two boats was 50 rupees plus 30 rupees, that is 80 rupees. So they had to give 80 rupees. And how much time did they two get for the two boats? Now see, time for the motorboat was 20 minutes and time for the rowing boat was 45 minutes. So total time will be 20 minutes plus 45 minutes and they got how much time? 65 minutes. I hope you can add this on your own. So they both got 65 minutes for the two boats. Now see, the students went to another boat and some students took a double decker. If they paid 450 rupees in all, can you tell how many students took the double decker? Now total money paid was 450 and fare of one child in double decker was 30 rupees. So in order to find how many students took double decker, we will divide 450 by 30. Here we go. 30 times 1 is 30 and subtracting we get 15 and we copy 0 from above and we get 150. And 30 times 5 is 150. So dividing 450 by 30, we get 15. So that means 15 students used a double decker boat. Can you tell which boat can take 2 rounds in an hour? So here you can see the time of paddle boat is 30 minutes. So that means it can take 30 minutes for the first round and 30 minutes for the second round. So total time is 60 minutes. So it is the paddle boat that takes 2 rounds in an hour. Now students, can you tell which boat takes less than half an hour for a round? Now, half hour means 30 minutes. So can you tell which boat is there which takes less than 30 minutes? Yeah, it is the motorboat. Motorboat takes 20 minutes, which is less than half hour. Can you calculate which boat gave more time and less money? Here you see, students, as you can see, paddle boat and rowing boat both have the same fare, that is 15 rupees. But paddle boat gives 30 minutes in those 15 rupees, whereas rowing boat gives 45 minutes in those 15 rupees. So that means rowing boat is the cheapest of all and it gives more time and less money. So students liked rowing boat the most, as it took less money and gave more time. Now Javed was a student. He took 2 boats. He paid 40 rupees and he got the time 50 minutes. Can you tell which 2 boats did he take for a ride? Now see, he had paid 40 rupees and had got 50 minutes. So that means Javed had used paddle boat and motor boat, as the fare for paddle boat and motor boat is 15 rupees and 25 rupees. That means total 40, and time for paddle boat is 30 minutes and time for motor boat is 20 minutes. So the time is 50 minutes. So if he paid 40 rupees and took 50 minutes, that means Javed had taken ride on a paddle boat and a motor boat. Now students, can you tell me, if one bus can carry 48 students, then how many students can go in 3 buses? Now this question is for you. You have to find it out. I'm waiting for your response. You can use your notebooks and pens. One bus has 48 students. And 3 buses will have how many students? So students, what will you do? You can multiply 48 by 3. Just do it. Okay, I hope you have solved it. I can tell you its answer. The answer is 144. So that means 3 buses can carry 144 students. And this 144 is nearest to which of these numbers? 100, 200 or 150. So 144 is nearest to 150. So we can say about 150 students can go in 3 buses. Can you tell which of these numbers will add to make more than 500? Is it 152 and 241? Or is it 321 and 192? Or is it 99 and 299? Or is it 401 and 91? Let's add these numbers and find out. You can take time to solve and add these pairs of numbers. See, 152 and 241 add to give 393. 321 and 192 add to give 513. You can match your answers with mine. 99 and 299 add to give 398, and 401 and 91 add to give 492. Our question was, which of these numbers add to give an answer more than 500? So you can clearly see which is more than 500. 513. So that means 321 and 192 add to make more than 500. Now you have seen the students who went on a trip. Now can you tell at what time what event would have happened? Crossing Narmada River. As they crossed Narmada soon after starting from the school, that is around 9. So that time will be 9:10 a.m. Watching pictures at Bhimbetka. As they might have reached Bhimbetka from 10 to 11, so they might have seen pictures after 11, that is around 11:30. Next is at the petrol pump. Now they crossed Narmada River and after that they reached the petrol pump. So that time will be around 9:30 in the morning. Next one is boating at the pond. So they took boating after lunch. So that time will be around 3 p.m. Now what was the lunch time? Lunch might be after they watched pictures at Bhimbetka. So this time will be around 12:30. And what would be the time at which they reached Hoshangabad back? It would be in the evening, that is around 6 p.m. So students, as you have seen, these students have enjoyed a lot on their trip. I hope and I'm sure whenever you have got a chance to go on a trip, or in future when you will get a chance to go on a trip, you will enjoy a lot. And I hope with this lesson you have done a lot of calculations and enjoyed this beautiful story. Thank you.